Hello, everybody!
Hello!
As you probably know, we speak mostly English, but we also try to speak with each other some German and Russian to learn them. And unfortunately, we're not speaking a lot of Spanish right now, though we hope that we can change it in future, no?
That's for sure, go.
Yeah, and today we decided to tell you about the words that we really, really like, and we use them no matter which language we are speaking right now. So, let's go!
Vamos! Auf geht's! Wir starten heute mit deutschen Wörtern.
Yeah, German words. Okay, let's go. There is one that we really like to use in all the languages because he at least says that it's not right when I say bun to this because it's actually not a bun. Bun, they say something like softer for...
Yeah, bun is to me softer like for hamburgers.
Yeah, like for hamburgers. And those, they use a lot, they eat a lot for breakfast and not only for breakfast, and they put all different kind thing on top of Brötchen?
Brötchen.
I cannot pronounce that good, it's a difficult sound. Brötchen.
Brötchen.
Yeah, and that's why we use it even when we speak English and we say something like, oh, what do we have tomorrow for breakfast?
Brötchen.
Let's have some Brötchen. As I already told in my previous video, there are a lot of German words that are so logic. They fit perfectly for a description and you don't need to describe in many words and to have a full sentence. You just have one word. Yes, a longer word many times, but still, the one that is fitting really good for even the difficult situation. So there is this word that we really like and we use no matter which language we speak. The German word is
Schweinehund. And it literally means pig dog. And we use it always in an expression that means to overcome your own pig dog.
Yeah. What is the German expression?
The expression is sein inneren Schweinehund überkommen. So to come over your inner pig dog.
Yeah, just imagine this strange, mysterious creature that is a pig and a dog at the same time living in you, and you try to fight with this creature always to do something good, to be persistent, to keep going, no?
Yes.
To do some sport or to go on a diet or whatever else you need some more inner strength to do.
Yeah, I always imagine it as the Cerberus, the hell dog that's protecting the hell. And you take him on the leash and then you go for a nice walk with this dog.
Yeah, such a nice walk. There is an example that we probably tell to all our friends, and this is a very nice one, so we'll also tell you. He says that the phrase in Russian, that's a word more, that means a little bit, sounds for him a lot like a train. Yeah. So to say a little bit in Russian, you say
shoot, shoot.
Choot choot.
And that sounds to me really like a train. Choot choot.
Actually, I really understand that for you it sounds like a train, though before it was totally impossible for me to imagine that, but it really sounds a bit as a train.
You're welcome.
And we also introduced them to the Russian cuisine. Okay, it's also a lot of questions if that's really Russian, not really Russian, not important. The dish that he likes a lot is called
Sirniki.
Sirniki. There is no an equivalent because it's something traditional in English, so we use this word always, Sirniki, and it's made from tvorak. It's a cottage cheese, and it's difficult to get this one in Europe, so he now struggles a lot because only here in Russia and in some countries in Eastern Europe, I guess, it's possible to find it. Yeah.
You introduced me to this dangerous thing and now I cannot even get it.
Yeah, and now every time you ask him, what would you like to have for breakfast? The answer is always the same.
Yeah, Sirniki. Пожалуйста.
And though we still speak English the most of the time, when we speak German or Russian, we realize that there are some English words that are just really good. And it's really good to use exactly those words and they describe things the best.
Yeah.
And the words we were thinking about are hardcore. I mean, you can probably explain that. I'm sure you can explain it in Russian and German, but it will take longer and not fit so perfectly.
Hardcore just fits and it goes smoothly over your tongue and we understand it all. And the other word in English is for sure random for me. I use it, I think, in every language.
That's good.
It some kind of, it has a deeper meaning to me than just random. I don't know. Maybe that's only in my mind, or maybe it has a special
meaning. It's only not for you. In Russian, we say randomna, so you can say choose a random song, выбрать песню randomna. It sounds a bit strange, but it's just, I'm okay with that because the word really fits.
And this word was so extremely difficult to remember in Spanish, and I think I still struggle with it.
I don't remember it right now. What was the Spanish one for random?
I think it was aleatorio.
If you're Spanish, just check that, check that aleatorio. Probably that was
it. Yeah, while learning Russian, all the knowledge
now the languages are mixing together in the head, and it's really funny sometimes.
Yeah, sometimes we say a word in a language that we did not want to say because we wanted to do the to
most
use
important
new
part
word.
we share most of the languages. The only language that I don't know at all that he speaks is Dutch, but luckily he's not telling a lot of Dutch words random, so I don't have problems with that.
Yeah, it's mostly I think Spanish.
Spanish words are coming randomly. Yeah,
speaking about the Spanish, those are our next words.
Yeah, I guess those are the words that we use a lot because we were in love with Spain and Spanish and we fall in love in Spain.
Yes.
So they are the words that we use a lot that are Spanish. And one of them is really a good characteristic of what we are sometimes, no?
Yeah, sometimes we are really cozy.
Cozy. The Spanish word that just really fits. And I like your description, if I'm allowed to tell you. It's like a princess all in pink and with the crown and with the diamonds and all the blinking stuff. It's like, well, if it's too much, you can say it's cozy. But you can also say that for the people in love who are just kissing and hugging all the time. Mm. Yeah, a bit like this. And though there are equivalents, in German, you said there is an equivalent. Kitschy.
Yeah.
And in Russian, you can say slashave, so it's connected with sweet. You can say like you're too sweet.
Yeah, we are.
Yeah, we are sometimes too sweet. That's true. And the other Spanish word was the one that we used in the beginning of the video.
Vamos.
It just sounds too good. Oh, we are too used to using this one.
I love that word so much. I remember the first months in Spain. Every time I heard that word, it was in my head directly, vamos a la playa,
That's true. And the vamos, the best translation would be like, let's go, all of us, let's go, let's start, let's keep, let's go. Yeah, that's the best probable explanation.
And next word was really difficult for us to learn in English.
Yeah.
And it's acquaintance.
Acquaintance. I don't know why, it's not so difficult, but somehow it was not in my head.
I also don't know. It took us time, and till we learned it, we always used conocido.
Yeah, the Spanish one, conocido, just someone you know, can be translated, and it's really good.
Yeah, and we use it still till today.
I
remember many times we are now saying, an acquaintance, and then we're like, conocido.
Conocido. And we want to finish with our last word, that is our favorite topic, the most favorite topic, and it's food.
Yeah, food.
And the word is the Spanish word empanada. You can buy empanadas everywhere in Spain. They are the small snacks. I guess the closest Russian translation that I have is pirozhok, and it can be with different filling. Do you know the German equivalent?
No, I'm always using empanada.
Empanada
now.
Yeah. And in English, as far as I got, there's only a pie, but pie is always a big one, and empanadas are mostly for snacking and they are small. So empanada, just a good word for any language.
And talking about all those words, we had the discussion, small discussion about if that's enriching for the language or if it's actually bad to use them.
I don't know, I think it's not so bad. Come on, when we use it playfully, said, I think it's a good description. It's not so bad, and it just shows that our world now is really connected and languages are evolving anyway, and they get some words from one another, and just some descriptions are better than other ones.
Yeah, and it shows also our experiences. I guess the Spanish words we use are mainly because we had those so
wonderful experiences. And yeah, and by the way, it's people sometimes are saying something like, you should keep your own language, you just should not forget about your own language while you're learning another one. But come on, we're not talking about forgetting our own language, we are teaching each other, for example, our languages. And for example, me learning German doesn't mean that I will not speak Russian. I even hope that he will speak Russian one day. So
I hope so too.
We're just even encouraging others also to keep your languages. I guess that's all for today, and bye.
Paka paka, do svidania.
And tschüss and auf Wiedersehen.
Hasta pronto.
Hasta luego, hasta la vista, and everything.